Tailwind is by far the worst kept secret in Pinterest marketing. Business-minded pinners swear by it, unable to scale at the rate they do without it. And yet, every time I bring it up, people who are new to Pinterest shrug it off as just another scheduling app. One that would be nice to have in a perfect world, but isn't worth their time, or it just feels a little too daunting to deal with. I literally showed somebody on a one-on-one call recently how Tailwind worked live, and it blew their mind. The simplicity of it, the power that it had to give them more time back into their content creating schedule. They literally told me that this was not the app or software that they thought it was. And you can get so much out of the free version. So even though I have my affiliate link linked in the description, know that I am not trying to sell you on something. I'm trying to put you onto a tool that will make your life easier. So let's dive into my Pinterest workflow. First, if I already have something to pin, I will go to drafts and just hit upload. Here you can browse or drag and drop images. These could be pins that you made in a graphic designer like Adobe Express or Canva, or maybe they are just simple static images with no text on them. Pro tip though, if you are uploading a static image, it does not hurt to throw it into Adobe Express and watermark it with your logo or your website to make it a little harder for other people to steal. From here, you can select one pin or many if you're doing a batch upload. Choose your post type. I'm doing Pinterest pins. And if you want to input your Pinterest titles and descriptions later, you can just click save as drafts. Or if you're ready to do it now, you can hit go schedule. And schedule is really where the magic happens, but we're gonna hold tight because I'm gonna show you the best way to make pins using Tailwind if you don't have anything made yet. So we'll just save this to drafts. So we're gonna go over to create and we're just gonna pull up my blog in another tab here. What's a good one? Let's make some more about camera backpacks. Okay, so as a blogger, the Tailwind Create feature is an absolute game changer. Step one is actually to make yourself a little brand kit under brand settings. Here you can input your website or brand name. You can choose your go-to fonts or actually upload your custom fonts if you don't align with any of the existing ones. You can upload your logo and your main color palette. Once that is done, go back to the design gallery and copy and paste the URL from the blog post you are wanting to make pins for. This is where the magic happens. What Tailwind does here is scan your blog post for images first. So you can go through and click any of the ones that you want to potentially include in your pins. Next, it also scans and pulls your title. The title of your blog post. So we have camera backpacks for women, the ultimate list. And if we scroll to the side, you can see it just generated, like, I don't even know how much, like thousands probably of potential Pinterest pins for us. There is also an option here to add subtitles as well as your branding. So I'm gonna select here, I want it to say creating with Kea, my website. And for text, I want the subtitle to actually be the ultimate list. So it kind of breaks it up a little bit. I then scroll through all of these options and keep an eye out for what I think is the most appealing. What's stopping me in my own scroll? Because then it's something that will probably stop somebody scrolling on Pinterest. You can also click and shuffle through different photo options as well as different layouts. And if you have more than one color in your brand palette, you can shuffle colors too, but for this one, I just have one. If one is almost perfect, but there's just like something that I don't quite like, I can actually go in and click the little pencil mark here and edit it, giving me full control just like I would in another graphic design editor. So I want to, you know, maybe italicize that one and maybe make it a little bit smaller. The ultimate list, is that centered? And then I just hit select. Perfect. And continue selecting. A best practice with Pinterest pins is to not have the exact same text on every single pin. So I like to go to the side here and mix up the title text and subtitles as I go. You can also filter by how many photos are shown, as well as what sort of categories this pin falls under. So if you hit blog post, it'll often have some really strong options. Then once I have a few that I like, I usually try to make 5 per blog post, but today we're just gonna do 3. We hit review designs, then we hit go schedule. Choose the Pinterest account you're pinning to, and confirm. Something I find a little glitchy is that you can't save to drafts directly from that previous create page. If you're not in the mood to fill out all of your titles and descriptions right now, you do have to like manually hit save for later on all of them to send to your drafts. Then for my friends who do not have a blog or a website, you can still use Tailwind Create to batch create a bunch of pins. Specifically, it works quite well with YouTube too, but I do recommend you actually manually upload your images because when you copy and paste a link into it, it's going to pull your entire thumbnail with the text overlays on top, like so. But it still does pull your title text, which is pretty cool. There are a few in here that might work that pull the whole horizontal image that makes it look like a YouTube video excerpt. But for the most part, I would just upload a clean slate image. You could technically do this with Instagram too, though it is unable to pull your image and it won't have a text, so you would just have to input that manually. But it is a great use case to batch create a bunch of pins that maybe direct to a super informative reel or a carousel. And now to schedule. Whether you want to schedule a single pin or a batch, you're going to go to drafts and select the ones you want to schedule. Bulk schedule. From here, you can complete your title and description as you please, or actually use Tailwind's Ghostwriter feature, which will pull a variation of title and description combinations based on your blog post. Some direction on what you're posting about, so I'm gonna say this is informational content, as well as the ability to add additional keywords or phrases that you're trying to rank for. Let's say cute camera bags, which is something I know a lot of people are actively searching for. And it does take one credit. I do have the paid version, so I do have 250 monthly credits. Generate pin details. I find that these do a pretty good job of setting the stage, but I still like to refine them to make them sound a little bit more like me and make sure that they have the keywords that I'm trying to rank for. A little cheat that Tailwind probably doesn't want me to share. It gives you three variations. So when I have multiple pins, I will actually copy and paste each one so that I can use all three options on a single credit. Is that bad? I don't really feel like I'm scamming them because I have 250 credits that I'm probably never going to be able to use in the month. And this is just more efficient than regenerating for every single pin. So we hit save details. I like to kind of take the emojis out actually. Cute camera bags, must have accessory for every photographer and content creator, adding in those extra keywords. Looking for a new camera bag that's as stylish as you are, that's pretty fun. But I'm going to just plug in some more specific keywords right at the beginning. The ultimate list of camera backpacks for women. Discover the best list. Let's actually say shop. Shop the best list. Okay. And again, not really big on the emojis, but it's fine. Then the next step is to choose the boards that are relevant to your pin, starting with the most specific board. So I have one for camera bags. I have another for content creation gear, you know, gear accessories. It kind of falls under that. And then I have one for my blog posts. You can actually schedule up to 10 different boards. This camera bag one is a pretty niche pin, so it only really applies to these three. Next step is to choose a date. These are all options recommended to me by my smart schedule, and that schedule is chosen by Tailwind based on what it thinks are my best times to post. So I will usually choose the first one. And then when it comes to the interval, i.e. how much time you want in between it going to the first board and the second board, I usually choose a weekly interval, and that is actually what is the best experience recommended for your audience. But I currently have so much content that I've just been choosing monthly for everything. And even at that rate, I have something going live on Pinterest every single day. And the final thing here is to add your pin to any relevant Tailwind communities. These are basically little niche focused groups on Tailwind where I can submit my pins to be posted by other people in the group and I will return the favor and post others. I find this helps further contextualize your pins for Pinterest and gives my content the chance to get even more reach. Again, this was a kind of a niche pin, but I think it would be relevant to like this bloggers and creative entrepreneurs one and amazing women entrepreneurs, because this is a list of camera bags for women. Add to communities. Ta-da! And from there, we just hit schedule post and repeat for the remaining pins. This part of filling out the titles and descriptions is probably the most tedious part of the process, but for every single one that you do, you are creating content for weeks, if not months, down the line, all depending on how many boards you selected and what interval rate you chose. I took a day a couple weeks ago to do this for all my outstanding blog posts on creating with Kea, using the create tool to make 5 pins for each one, and I scheduled them all out until October. I think some even go past October. These little dots are how many pins are scheduled for that day. We've got dots, June, July. It gets a little bit more sparse, but we're still in August, still some in September, still some in October, still some in November. That's crazy. And this means that even if I forget about Pinterest for a little bit, or if I feel really swamped by the weight of other platforms, I'll still be present and consistent on it thanks to Tailwind. If you do want to give it a try, I definitely, like I said, recommend using the free version. And you can sign up for it using the link in my description. It is an affiliate link. I won't get anything unless you do choose to pay for it like I do, but you registering through the link does still help me as I can track conversions and, you know, maybe present that to Tailwind. If I try to pitch them one day, it might make them want to work with me. So it'd be greatly appreciated. And if you want to continue to level up on Pinterest and start making money, watch this next. Thanks for watching and until next time.